Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our science demonstration entitled The Sheep and the Goats. And I'm going to ask Ashley to open that up for our internet classroom because I need to move over to the place that our demonstration is going to take place. We have a tub of water here. And this tub of water represents the world, so to speak. You and I are in this world. We're Christians in the world, yes. But we're going to use soda pop cans. Now, a very kind gentleman at our local hardware has donated these cans for us because we didn't have any soda at home. Jay at our local hardware gave us these cans to use in our demonstration. And this first one is called Mr. Pastor. I'm putting him in the water. This next one is called Miss Sabbath School Teacher. She goes in the water too. Remember, this is the world that we are all among. Cheerful Christian Girl is the next one. Ashley, can you read this one? Who is this?
Mr. Deacon.
Mr. Deacon. He's in the world too, but a Christian. Who's this?
Mrs. Pathfinder.
Mrs. Leader. Pathfinder Leader is there also. And one more.
Happy Christian Boy.
They're all in this water, which represents the world that we are all walking among and making decisions and shopping and buying and everything. But all of these cans are floating, so to speak. See, we're just kind of floating along in this world. Whether we're a happy Christian or Mr. Deacon, Pathfinder Leader, we're floating along. Okay, now, we're going to ask our pastor to empty this water and put new water in because a time is coming, the end of time, when the sheep and the goats will be separated. So, yes, we're taking out Mr. Deacon and Mr. Pastor and Pathfinder Leader and everyone. And while he's doing that, I want us to move ahead in our little slideshow to slide number 2, taken from Matthew 25:32. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them from one another, as a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats. And these cans, which represent all of us as Christians, whether we're teachers or boys and girls, and Pastor is now filling up our tub again with water. While he's doing that, I want to tell you about the density of water. We're in slide 3. The density of water is 1 gram per cubic meter. Slide 4 shows water and how ice is less dense than liquid water, so it floats. Slide 5. When an object has a density that is greater than the medium it is placed in, that object, don't put anything in yet, that object will sink. So think about it. When the object has a density greater than the water, it's going to sink. Now, slide 6. If the density of the medium is greater than the density of the object, in other words, if the density of water is greater than what you put in the water, that object is going to float. So for example, hydrogen, and I'm on slide 7, hydrogen has a density that is lighter than air. And that's the reason when a balloon is filled with hydrogen, it floats in the air. This is hydrogen. They have hydrogen balloons. Copper has a density that is greater than the density of water. So, when copper is placed in water, it sinks. Now, question. Wood has a density that is less than water.
Float.
It floats. It doesn't sink. Now, the materials you need, this is slide 10, is just a tank, and you fill it with tap water, and unopened soda cans. Some regular, some diet soda. Okay, so now we have water again. Let's put these people back in. Here goes Mr. Deacon.
Mr. Pastor.
Mr. Pastor, happy Christian boy.
Cheerful Christian girl.
Cheerful Christian girl.
Miss Sabbath School Teacher.
Miss Sabbath School Teacher.
Miss Pathfinder Leader.
Do we need more water?
No.
Because... okay. All right. The purpose of this experiment is, yes, is that the diet soda people, Mr. Pastor in this example and Mr. Deacon here, they float because they do not have sugar in their composition. They have chemicals to make it sweet. Therefore, the density of diet soda is less than the density of Cheerful Christian Girl, for example, a regular soda can. That sinks. Now, sometimes you will get a regular soda can that doesn't sink, and that's because inside maybe a bubble is there, a bubble of air, or it has been shaken up or whatever, and keeps it from sinking. But definitely all the diet sodas are floating, and two-thirds of the regular soda are sinking. Now, what this means, I forgot to get a paper towel. What this means, and I'm going to have to move on with my other hand here. Thank you. Okay. Let's see if we can get this to work. There we go. Slide 11 shows a picture of what we've done. We've taken a big tub of water and slide... There we go. Slide 12 shows a bucket of soda cans floating away there. If you look closely, you'll see one that's sunk. So we know the ones that are floating, and you can see diet on one of them, are diet cans, and the one that has sunk is a regular soda. Now, slide 14 shows you an example of what we've done here on our video. Diet sodas float, regular soda sinks, and that's because the regular soda has a higher density than the others. Slide 15 shows you another example of two cans in water. Now, let's move on to slide 17. Whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Now, what I want you to realize is, on the outside, we may all look the same. We're cheerful Christians, we're happy Christians, we work in the church as Pathfinder leaders, or teachers, or pastors, or deacons, or whatever. But a time is coming when Jesus is going to separate the sheep from the goats. And just like in this little demonstration, separation is taking place. Some soda cans are floating, and some soda cans are sinking. Some are sheep, and some are goats. And we want to be part of those that are staying afloat with Jesus. Remember about the five wise virgins and the five foolish virgins? There comes a time when they want what the five wise have, but it's too late to obtain it. And when Jesus separates the sheep from the goats, it will be too late to change. The separation is occurring. But now, while we have time, while we are all, so to speak, kind of floating along in this world of ours, let's make a decision for God and to stay faithful to Him, so that when trials and tribulations come, they won't get us down. We have a connection with our Heavenly Father, and we will float above our troubles and not end up sinking beneath all the troubles and tribulations and problems that we have. So, let's be good, faithful Christians to the end, because when God separates us, we don't want to be part of the goats. Thank you. And until we meet again, may God bless you.